Now that you've added the URI information to the weather contract, step two of building our content provider, I've got some explaining to do. At the beginning of our weather contract, you can see we defined the content authority. Next, we added strings for the base paths for our URIs. Note how these paths match our two tables. For each of our tables, location entry and weather entry, we created a content URI that represents the base location for each table. Something else that is convenient to have in the contract are functions to help build the content provider queries. Now, for some URI builders and decoder functions for weather entry, it's convenient to have these, as it makes fewer places in your code aware of the actual URI encoding, keeping this knowledge in the contract. Strings such as the location setting can be appended with the append path function. You'll be implementing the build weather location function shortly. In this case, adding an additional path to the URI does not change the type of the URI, so they're both type dir. We can also use these functions to add potentially useful query parameters. In this case, we use a query parameter for the start date. Query parameters are useful for when we have a fixed database query that we want to have some limited parameterization for. In this case, it will be a parameter for our join between the two tables. More on that later. URI queries look just like the queries you see in web URLs and give us the ability to add more richness and complexity to our URI contract. Finally, we have this function that builds a two-part URI with both weather and date segments. Below this, we have helper functions that hide the URI structure from our code for retrieving values from the URI and place all this knowledge in one place. Looking back at our list of URIs, you can see that for each URI, I called out whether the URI returned a list of items by labeling it with dir for directory, or a single item by labeling it with item. Cursors returned from a content provider have unique types based upon their content and the base path used for the query. Android uses a form similar to the Internet Media Type or MIME type to describe the type returned by the URI. Cursors that can return more than one item are prefixed by the cursor dir base type string, while cursors that return only a single item are prefixed by the cursor item base type string. We defined these types here for both the location and the weather queries.